Welcome to the Society for the New Moon's Paradigm on, help me out, March
10th.
Thank you. So we have got a lot of momentum building on the new paradigm around the world. The new paradigm has had some legs for a while. Ever since 2013, we've been, as a movement, who part of the international movement that originally made the proposal for the World Land Bridge, to see the New Silk Road going in the direction that it's going has been exciting, to say the least. Because, of course, it's more than just an economic plan. It is a cultural plan. It is a political plan. It is for everybody in society, top down. And so we've had a lot of developments in this regard. And I'd like to call them the new paradigm momentum, especially in the last couple of weeks, which Paul will be going through. Also, Phil's going to be giving a presentation tonight specifically on the implications of Putin's announcement. I don't know if any of you had heard, but Putin made an announcement on March 1st. And it was in the context of, basically a State of the Union address to the Russian people, the equivalent of that. And he showcased and announced their weapons capabilities. So Phil's going to go through that tonight. I'm just going to take care of a couple of housekeeping things and give you a briefer on the society in the context of Canada and BC, especially. Now, because of your donations, because of your support, because of your involvement, we have been able to attend some very important events. I have been able to take the time to be able to write about those events. I've had two articles published on the Sacred blog. But I want to just take a moment to say that while my name is on those articles, it is only because of the dialogue that we have with everybody in this room that those articles are actually written. So it's not just me. It is the society as a whole. And this includes dialogue that we have at this meeting. It includes one-on-one dialogues that some of us have. It includes our working group dialogues that we have about our activities and in talking about world events and in the context of Canada. So that has done our society a great service, because every time an article gets published and there's a link in the society, in the article for the society, our Facebook page gets a lot of hits, our website gets a lot of hits.
Paul got the Kim Jong-un haircut. Very popular in NK right now.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
And now back to the meeting.
Yes.
It's okay.
It's the downside of that app.
It's significant, the amount of impact that it has. The first article was entitled Canada's Nazi Problem. And that article is almost at 15,000 hits. So it's 15,000 people that have read that article.
15 or 50?
15,000. And the second article, which was published, I think it was on Tuesday or Wednesday, is almost at 10,000. So, you know, this is exposure. It's not just, you know, so that people know our name. It is so that they're getting the information, so that they're getting the ideas, most important. And that is why we exist, for the Society for the New Moon's Paradigm, to get the idea of what is the new paradigm out into society as a whole, into our personal meetings, and into in-person meetings, and also in the blogosphere. Now, one of those events that I have attended lately was very significant. I met the Vice President of the Bank of China for Canada. And she couldn't tell me at the time. What I asked her specifically was, could the municipalities, the governments in Canada, at all levels, municipality, provincial, federal, go to the Bank of China and ask and get a loan for infrastructure. And I knew the answer, but I was really good to hear it from her, and so we had a dialogue about it. And of course, the answer was yes, of course. Of course, anyone in Canada, you know, any government body can do this. Because the Bank of China, everywhere around the world, is 100% commercial. There's no speculation. She gave where I met her was at a presentation on mining. And mining around the world generally is a speculative activity, financially. So needless to say, her presentation was not well received. But they come with a lot of money, a lot more money than a lot of these other people currently have, due to the fact that they aren't engaging in speculation. So when I asked her about this, she was quite happy to hear the question. She was happy to hear that our society existed. She was also very happy to hear that we were in meetings with municipalities and others to encourage this kind of activity, to encourage them to go to the Bank of China, Canada, to get a loan. Because that's going to cost all of us a lot less money. A week after, one last thing. I asked her if, or she told me that they were already in discussion with one municipality. And she could not tell me which municipality it was. Fair enough. A week later, the Telebridge announcement happened. Oregon announced that it was happening. So this was, and if you understand how the government structures work, that Horgan announced it, but because it's in the city of Surrey and in the city of New Westminster, they all had to come together, right? We still don't know exactly where the funding came from, but it's pretty interesting that happened. So I'm just laying some context here. I'm not making any specific statements, but in regards to provincial politics and where our provincial politics overlaps with the new paradigm, with the One Belt, One Road, with Canada-China relations. My latest article goes into what a particular layer of Canadian state is trying to spread about that. So I encourage you to read it, because they're really peddling this anti-China thing. And so I'd be very careful about what you're reading. And I'm not saying that believe everything that we say or believe everything that Rochester and Schiller Institute says. That's not the point of this. The point is to find out for yourself. And there's a lot of direct activity that is being reported on about China's activities in Africa, as an example, and most importantly about the, like I said, you know, a really good example of this is listening to the Bank of China woman talk to these mining experts who don't share the same financial principles. When you say that your bank is 100% commercial and that you will not open your financial system to speculation, that is a very humanist policy. I'm not saying that this is a blanket statement that goes for everything that China does. That's also not the point. But that is a policy that our government can get behind and should get behind, or that we should be supporting our government to get behind. So that's the context of the BC Liberals and the BC NDP Greens right now, because the Chinese population in BC is very high and they're very significant. They have a large impact on the voters in terms of voting, and they have an impact on the policies that the governments are going to adopt. And we saw this from an event that we went to yesterday. So I won't get into that in great depth, but it's something that we're going to be looking at a lot closer. It is part of the dynamic that we're organizing around for our July conference. Our July conference date is not set yet, but we're going to be, basically what I'm trying to get across here is that the donations and the support that you give us are helping us get this policy on the table. with our governments. And we are a voice in that realm. So the new paradigm momentum is, of course, all bringing in the context of what's happening here in BC and in Canada. Now, we have, I just wanna make one announcement. We have decided that we're going to be doing a continuous fundraiser. And so you're gonna be hearing an announcement at every meeting going from this day going forward that we have a prize. And we're selling tickets, so it's a raffle. And so right now the tickets are one for $10 and three for $20. This is an iRobot Roomba vacuum, and it is, I guess, goes for a regular $700.
Yeah, what?
Yeah, so it's a very nice machine. And I'm not going to do the whole anyway thing. The runner-up prize is this
consolation prize.
Very, very nice thermos. So I have the tickets. If you would like to purchase a ticket, we're going to be selling 150 tickets altogether. And from then, we're just going to wait until all 150 tickets are sold, and then we'll draw it at the end of that. So if you're interested, come and find me afterwards. I'll have the tickets and then we'll rig them up and we'll get them that way. So we're going to be doing this, like I said, regularly. We'll always have some sort of prize to raffle off. And all of this money is going to be going for our July conference and also just to keep us going as well. But we're going to be printing, where's the... You have a copy? No.
Yeah, I do.
Sorry.
I would like to say a few things on that.
Can you wait until your presentation?
Sure.
Okay. So this is what LPAC has done in the United States. Now, what we're doing is we are creating the same thing for Canada. No other organization is capable of doing this or is doing it. And because we have this incredible material and the ideas, the meat I like to call it, is here for us. We're putting it together. We're going to be publishing however many copies, probably 1,000 to start, and then we're going to be selling them. But we also are going to be getting these in the hands of the politicians that we need.
Yes. It's going to be explosive.
Yes. So basically, this is the four laws. And this is the foundation. And by the way, this is the exact same four laws. It may not be explained in this manner, but it's the exact same principles that have enabled countries like China and other countries around the world to get on their feet economically and to have a stable system. So the four laws are Glass-Steagall, national banking, which would, for Canada, it would be a Bank of Canada, infrastructure plan, an actual infrastructure building plan, and then the fourth one is a science driver. So we're going to be laying this out at the July conference. We're going to be having Helga Zeparush is going to be keynoting over Skype. We'll have a couple of speakers, one from BC and possibly one from Washington State, who are going to be speaking about the One Belt, One Road from a Canadian and American perspective. And then Paul's going to be presenting on this. And this is our program going forward. And until this is done, we're going to be here hammering away at it. So, I will leave it
That's good enough. I don't need to
Okay. Robbie, so, yes.
Can you just tell them that we were going to be giving out tickets for people to sell wherever they can as well, within our own group?
For the fundraiser.
Yes.
Yes. This is only kind of our temporary right now. We didn't get enough printed for today, but we're going to have a lot more. So if you want to buy some or just take some, I'll write it down how many you take, and then sell them to friends, that would be equally as great, and I'm sure they'd be happy to win an iRobot. Thank you. So, on that note,
Your banking, number two. Mm-hmm. So, you were to say use the Bank of Canada instead of other banks?
Yes, of course, of course. The problem right now is that the municipalities have nowhere to go. Like, I mean, they can get a loan, but it costs so much more.
We'll be putting together the whole package from bank separation to reestablishing the Bank of Canada to bank, you know, all of it. It's all going to be put together in one place.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'm going to get Phil up here. He's going to be doing a presentation now on Putin's announcement, and then Paul will be giving us an update.